Here is how I use my iPhone. The control center, you guys know that. Control center is neat, and you can customize it in settings to show whatever you want on there. But you know, it's got Shazam, QR codes, calculator, wallet, camera, magnifier. So those are all really cool, useful tools that you can access directly right there from the control center. And then I just live in a notification dashboard, because it has the time, the date, the music that's playing, pause, play, fast forward, next song, and then it has all my notifications. So if I ever get a notification for a text message, which click the boom tab, takes me directly to that message, and then I just swipe back down, back to the same home page. Essentially, the home page is the same, because you would swipe up to go home, right? So let's see here, I go to Instagram, swipe back down, back at home, instead of swiping up. Now I just swipe to the right, and get access to all kinds of things. So these apps on the top there are dynamic. Dynamic meaning they are based on my usage and what time I use them. So they automatically update and change. And that's a default feature with the new iOS 14. So no programming done there. Below the apps there, there's stackable widgets. And these are all widgets that I did not have to do any design on. Just add widget, stack it, and then you can scroll through the different sections. So here's booking my flights, for example. Here's my maps. Here's my Google search. Here's my email. Here's my upcoming appointments. Here's the world clock. Here's my battery, all that. So very accessible, very easy. And then I love this calendar that's 2 months out, so that I can see what's upcoming as far as dates. And then here I have my internet and data usage that's live and update. As you can see, the graph is just updated and just running 24/7. And then my storage. And then I have a couple quick default buttons that I wanted to just feature there. One is look at my car, and then the other one is get a phone call. So if you want to get away from someone, don't want to be impolite, tap that button. You get a phone call, you can say, hey, I gotta go, I'll take this call, I'll talk to you later. Cool way to get out of a situation. And then all these widgets, they're all built in default. No programming, guys. I just add them on there. Cash App, time, the travel time, WhatsApp contacts, stock market, my business cards. These are all default. You just go to edit, add widget, log in, boom, done. And then you swipe left back to the notification center. You see if you have anything new, check in there. If you don't, just let your phone be and continue by your life. Now these are custom. I did build these custom. So this is a menu that has direct access to the things I wanted to. It has a toolbox, it has a social media toolbox. So I can access social media accounts super easily from anywhere, any screen. I just tap the button there. This is my Photoshop Media Center, where I can edit videos, I can rotate photos, I can combine photos, I can frame photos. These are the things that I do every day for work. So I like to have them super accessible. And then I have another menu that pops up from the bottom there, and that has some other cool features. And those are all customizable to put whatever you want. So I can dictate some words into 64 languages. I can send a voice memo and a text at the same time. I can do smart text, which is text anyone from anywhere without getting into the messages app. My wallet, which also loads Cash App, Venmo, and all that all at the same time. So these are all some just really cool accessible features. Those are customizable. But like I said, the first half of the video here was all default with phone. So here's the smart text, for example. So I just typed the person's name, comma, type the message, and then I click done, message sent, bye. Don't have to do anything else. I can live on that homepage and not have to really go anywhere.